Hi, my name is Kyle Knotek. Most of the people in the coaching world and the professional soccer circuit near the Chicago soccer area know me by this name. But my fantastic players and their wonderful parents know me by another name, Soccer Coach Kyle. Before we start, I want to give you a little background on me. I spent most of the last 5 or 6 years playing professional soccer, or football if you want to call it that, in Europe. In 3 different countries. When I was at home, I signed 3 professional contracts here in the USL. I spent most of my youth career playing for the number 1 ranked men's soccer club in the entire country. And as a college player, I was a 4-year Division I starter, 2-time academic All-American. But I think at all of these levels, at all of these times looking back, I noticed that there were so many skills that I needed for those levels that I wasn't introduced to, and obviously no one had explained how to do them either. And what I recognized when I was transitioning to become a professional is that I needed to take a perspective of individual skill acquisition and understanding. Maybe you can flip those around, understanding and acquisition. So I had to identify the skills I needed and I had to pick up those individual skills. I knew if I had those individual skills, then the bigger picture would come together. So go back to my professional career. I'm in Sweden, a bit older in my career now. And I remember one night thinking, why am I doing this? My family, my friends, not being able to coach players or my players, my car, Amazon Prime, all of these things are at home and speaking English, you know, and you take these things for granted, but I couldn't do them all the time over there. And it got to a point where I was like, well, I think I would be much happier and comfortable going back home, using my 4.0 business degree, getting a normal job. But I had a revelation that night. I thought back and I just thought about the players who I had been able to mentor and coach. And I thought about the differences I had made in their lives. And I had seen it and heard it from the parents. And I said, maybe it's bigger than me. Maybe it's about something bigger than me. And I said, from that day on, I can make a giant impact, not only with the players I'm coaching, but what I can do with the game, what I can teach, what I can start. I said, I'm going to continue this journey because I think this journey has the potential to help me make a bigger impact. So I'm going to go with this journey as long as it gets better on a team perspective and an individual perspective. As long as I'm still pushing and the environment's getting better, I'll continue to go. And from that moment on, it did. Maybe I got a better focus and energy, a drive for my why. But I helped my team promote that year in Sweden. Next year, we were in a higher level. I played pretty much every game, but then I was seen by a Brazilian coach who was coaching a Slovakian team that was owned by a top Brazilian side, and he pulled me over. They were in a really bad situation. He pulled me over to help them get out of that relegation or that bottom zone. I did help him with that. I had a great season. I did have some injury problems at the end. I didn't play much in the last 5 games for many reasons, and that made it difficult. A lot of coaches that were interested in me weren't looking at me anymore. That maybe pushed them away. It is what it is. I think it's God's way of telling me that it's time for me to call it quits without a serious injury or something happen. And I did have opportunities, but I didn't have an opportunity at a higher level, which is what I promised myself and I told myself. So after it was all said and done, I came back. I was maybe as fit physically and technically as I'd ever been, but it got to a point where I said, I can make a bigger difference back home. I'm not learning anymore at this time. I can't plateau with where I'm going, or I can't stay at the same level. I need to go home and make a difference with the game. And that's what I'm trying to do now. I'm actually working with G3X Sports and G3X Soccer to make the biggest difference with this game that I can, because that's the most important thing, is the difference I can make with it. Because as athletes, youth athletes, pro athletes, I think we forget sometimes that sports is a metaphor for life. Of course, it's just a game. I mean, sports are a game, right? But if players, especially at a younger level, can see that they can develop in a game, like we said, it's a metaphor for life. I can develop as a person too. I can get this growth mindset versus a fixed mindset where, you know, I'm only as good as I'm good as I am. I'm not going to get much better. So that's what I want to do now. It's not just about them turning into better soccer players. It's about them turning into better people. And I tell you what, one of my biggest goals and my biggest hopes is that they can use the beautiful game and pay it forward to someone else. because that's the biggest part. That's my mantra right now. That's the biggest, most important part for me is to pay it, the pay it forward part. And as we see, the beautiful game brings us all together. It's a world sport, but it also helps us make a difference in other people's lives in our own way. So that's my goal. And a little bit about my training. I've had a lot of injuries, so I know the anatomy and physiology of the body, and that helps me teach moves to these players. It helped me teach myself, and it helps me teach it to these players, because I was never natural, putting in twice as much work as almost every other player in the team. You can ask any of my teammates that I played with. They can go tell you I was doing extra work, hours on hours of extra work, and I was doing extra recovery work so I can do that type of extra work. So I'm never natural. I always outworked other players, but at the end of my career, I started to work smart. That really helped me. And that's what I want them to do. I want to introduce them to skills. I want them to work smart, not just hard. And I want to see what we can do with their game and what we can do with their life. My coaching style, I'm extremely positive, inspirational, positive reinforcement, intrinsic motivation. These are things, I've had coaches both ways, but these are the coaches that made a difference in my life, and I've learned that's how I want to coach. No punishment, no negative reinforcement, none of these things. I'm very detail oriented and particular about what I want, but I'm able to get it, pass it along, or kind of communicate it to them in a way that keeps their confidence high and keeps them focused on the training, so they can do, you know, very technical drills that maybe aren't the most fun, but they can get the most out of it, and we can have fun at the same time. It's about having fun too, right? It's about learning skills, but having a good time. And I think all of my players can tell you, and their parents, it's a good time. Kids learn a lot. I'm really excited to potentially have the opportunity to work with you or your child, whoever I'm speaking to, whether it's on a private level or a small group, 4 to 5 players, or anywhere in between there. I think we can find the investment level that works for you, and so we can help your child grow in the game and inevitably grow as a person and an individual. So I'm really excited. If you have any questions, reach out to me in any way. I'll get back to you, and I really appreciate your time and consideration. I'm really looking forward to hearing from you or seeing you in the near future. Thank you so much.